the corner of the forest, in a cozy, glowing house, live the kindest Mr. Bear and his very best friend, Mouse. Mr. Bear had thought he lived alone, till Mouse appeared one day. They soon became the best of friends, and Mouse then chose to stay. Mr. Bear loves little more than breakfast in his bed, and his scarf and shiny teacup in his favourite colour, red. Some other things to tell you that Mr. Bear loves most are Christmas time and snowfall and letters in the post. As winter fell and snow came down, Mr. Bear was thinking. He'd hold a feast for all his friends, with merriment and drinking. He headed out into the snow, with lots of invitations. Excitedly, he posted them and dreamt of celebrations. The day before the winter's feast, Mr. Bear was testing sherries. While out into the snowy wood, Mouse went hunting berries. Storm came in with lots of snow, and Mouse was soon quite lost. No path to find, or tracks to trace, her paws nipped by the frost. As night drew in, Mouse wasn't home, and Mr. Bear was worried. He had to try and find her. Into the storm, he hurried. Mr. Bear went home. He couldn't bear to think of Mouse, out lost at night, alone. Mr. Bear had hardly slept. The party was soon due. He'd been busy baking mince pies, but his heavy heart felt blue. Mouse had found a nice spot, tucked underneath a tree. Had nibbled lots of berries. And a robin made her tea. Friends arrived at Mr. Bear's. Concern grew in the house. They couldn't bear to celebrate without their dear friend Mouse. Meanwhile, Mouse had spotted torchlight and now knew which way to go. Moving fast, Mouse followed onwards, finding footsteps in the snow. The party was quite quiet, though the mince pies were a treat. Everyone was hoping for the sound of tiny feet. Outside, the snow was sparkling. Mouse wasn't far away. She could see the house all twinkling as she hurried on her way. It had never looked so cozy as Mouse walked towards the door. There's just no place like home, she thought. I couldn't ask for more.